Hi, I'm Aditi Saha, one of the software engineers on Azure Active Directory Connect Cloud Sync team. In this short video, I'm going to go over on-demand provisioning and how you can use this feature. On-demand provisioning allows you to provision a single user to Azure Active Directory on demand. It lets you bypass the regular synchronization cycle. Among other things, you can use this capability to troubleshoot configuration issues, test scoping filters, test custom attribute mapping expressions, etc. Without further ado, let's jump straight into a quick demonstration of this feature. This demonstration assumes you have already installed Cloud Sync Agent in your on-premises server, and you have already configured Azure AD Connect Cloud Sync to sync identities from on-premises to the cloud. So I'm going to head over to Azure portal and log in using my global administrator account. Next, I'm going to navigate to Azure Active Directory, which I can search from over here. Once the page loads up, we will be able to see that I am logged in using my global administrator account. Next, let's move on to Azure AD Connect, which will let me manage the configuration from the cloud. As you can see, I have multiple configurations, one associated with each domain. For the purposes of this demonstration, I'm going to go ahead and select this domain that I am going to use. Once I click on the domain, it takes me to the Edit Cloud Sync Configuration page. Here, there are many configurations to play with. However, I'm going to go to Validate, which will let me validate the configuration on a single user before you enable the configuration for everyone. So I click Provision a User. This takes me to the Provision On-Demand experience. In this experience, you can enter the Active Directory distinguished name of a single user. I'm going to go ahead and pick a user from my domain. This user is Test User 1. To trigger the whole flow, I can click on Provision. Once I click on Provision, provisioning service is actually going to go ahead and import this user from Active Directory and provision this user to Azure Active Directory. This operation has succeeded, and I see that this user was updated in Azure Active Directory. There are other operation details like the attributes that were actually modified in Azure Active Directory. Once I click on this export details window, I can actually see the steps that were performed by the provisioning service. Step one, which is not even listed here, is test connection. In this step, provisioning service determines if it is authorized to access the target system, which is Azure Active Directory. Please note that this step doesn't even show up unless that step fails. The next step is import user. In this step, provisioning service actually imports the user from Active Directory. If the user was imported successfully, it goes on to determine if the user is in scope, which is our next step. The next step is match user between source and target system. In this step, provisioning service tries to determine if there is a mapping between the source system user and the target system user. The next step is perform action, where provisioning service actually goes ahead and performs the action of creating, updating, or deleting the user from Azure Active Directory. Please note that currently this feature is only available for user object types. This concludes my demonstration. As you can see, I was able to successfully provision a single user from Active Directory to Azure Active Directory by bypassing the regular synchronization cycle, which happens every X number of minutes. Thank you for watching and have a lovely day.